So, I mean, it's looking like 4-1 here, buddy. What are you playing? That's my question.
Earl offended somebody.
Jesus Christ. I swear, dude. I'm going to smack a bitch and say some stupid shit.
It's all right. I just removed them. But nice. what I was going to say was the whole HDR thing. This is an open for discussion type of thing, because I'm still learning about HDR, which is a shock, because you would have thought Mark Cerny would have sealed that up with, you know, how well they talked about this feature, although they couldn't show you it. HDR actually requires graphical oomph, like some power. So this is what I think. There's games on your PlayStation 4 console.
Morning.
That runs at 1080p, not lock 60, and it dips frequently because you may have more blades of grass.
Hello, Roxas.
How is it that you're going to have those games running in HDR if they get a patch and run just as good?
I wanted to meet you at least once.
Am I correct here? Yes. Is it going to run worse because it's going to be having HDR?
98% of that processing is done on the side of the TV. So that's why I say HDR is fairly easy to implement. It can be fairly automatic.
Oleg dragged me along to go shopping.
And it's not really much work at all.
Hey, you want to come with us?
It really does depend on the TV. That's why you get evolution kits with, like, let's say, Samsung TV.
Did you just see that?
$400 and essentially buy a new processor as well as HDMI 2.0 ports to stick one in the back of your TV.
Very well, then. We'll see you later, Roxas.
To give your TV more boost to push out that wider color gamut.
Yeah.
So most of that's done on the side of your actual display.
Did she go to that haunted mansion?
Am I the only person who still doesn't get the whole HDR thing after that press conference? I hope that they...
It just basically allows for more shades of every single color. You're going from like 16 million colors to well over a billion with HDMI or with HDR 10-bit, so...
Yeah, the colors are just much more vibrant. They're very... You know, a lot of people don't understand when people say the whites and the black colors that come through on these new TVs. And the best black color that used to come through back in the day was the plasmas, you know, and the Kuro, the Pioneer Kuro.
They still are the best too.
Absolutely. I totally agree with you. And now, you know, the OLEDs and the technology that will be, you know, the successor to those are the ones that are worth. Those are why those get so much more money. And there's definitely a lot of tech behind too. But
let me go.
To be honest with you, Food, the HDR thing, I think Crap said this yesterday. The HDR thing is bigger than the 4K thing. Mm-hmm. In the long run, because that's what's gonna pop on your television. Resolution is one thing, but I want those true rich colors.
Chicken wuss,
you know.
Who's that?
Somebody shaving?
I don't know.
Somebody's doing something.
But they've already crossed the line.
That's amazing.
Find a weapon.
So the thing is that I remember this was like a CES show that was years ago, and they were showing consumers just trying to get a feel of what it is that they're looking for. They have a 1080p image at 60 frames a second with HDR support, and then they have a 4K image at 30 frames a second, and they asked me, what would you prefer? And everybody, absolutely everybody, chose 1080p 60 with HDR support. And that's why I totally agree with you whenever you say that this is where it's at in the long run. Not just because of this trial that they had here, just control test that they did there, but it's about the colors. I mean, if you can see, we're gamers. If you can see the environment better, we're playing a Twitch shooter, you know, it's gonna help us
Roxas,
improve.
Yes, use the keyblade,
all that noise helps, but resolution always goes up in time, but necessarily colors don't. We don't get this kind of jump that we're getting right now in terms of color palettes going into the billions. So it's extremely important. And if it's true with what Dealer Gaming is saying, with the PlayStation 4 getting this gimped version of HDR, I can't really see it.
Well, the PlayStation Slim and the PlayStation Launch ones are the ones. I mean, the Pro will get real HDR.
Yeah.
That's going to get real HDR. The problem is Sony was trying to sell people HDR on the older PS4s, which, if you look, there's no content. It's just a menu option right now. Because it can't upscale even to do the 4K stuff. And so you can't watch 4K Netflix on the standard PS4. So you can't access HDR because it's a 4K thing. So, you know what I mean? So it's basically just a bunch of worthless crap. Yeah. And so basically that's all it is. It's nothing. It was Sony trying to do exactly what they did. Oh man, Sony's so great, aren't they? Look, they gave everybody free HDR. Microsoft trying to sell you an Xbox One S to get it. Those bags, come on.
Man, something I wanted to touch up on now that I have a Mooch here is, I remember it was possibly like 2 weeks ago. Correct me if I'm wrong. I really do think it was you, Mooch. Was it you that said you think that the PlayStation 4 Pro is competing with the PlayStation 4? Okay, I was thinking with the
because to be honest with you, at the end of the day, okay, I'll use a couple of the wise words from facetious crap. He said, "How is the PS4 Pro going to get any more 1080p here?" And here's the thing: 90% of the games, yes, they're all going to be upscaled to 4K, but so is the Xbox One S. So what I'm saying to you is, what is it truly, except for the remasters that we're going to be getting from Sony, that we're going to get in 4K? We've heard it from Albert Pinello, and Albert Pinello is actually quoting all the head developers of the big major publications, like Mr. Howard, that works for Bethesda, and all these other guys. They got the numbers for Scorpio, 6+ T+, because that was necessary from the developers' mouths for true 4K native gaming. 4.2 TFLOPS is not enough. So, if it's not enough, it's not as high as Scorpio, and yes, it's got more, but not enough to make a difference from the PS4 vanilla and Xbox One S. So, when you're talking about competing, let's not compete in the same house, that's ridiculous. Let's talk real competition. The PS4 Pro is going against the Xbox One S. And if you go, well now, Mooch, give me another example. I will. You have 4K Blu-ray player in the Xbox One S, you have 4K Blu-ray player in the Pro. Those are the competing brands. So the best part about the end of this little spiel of mine is Scorpio's coming out with no competition. Scorpio has no competition.
Well, it's here's the thing, right?
Anyone that wants better gaming or 4K anything natively, is you have one product to buy for 2017, 2018, and 2019, and that's the product of Scorpio.
Well, here's the thing, right? Like, for the PS4 Pro, I was like, well, is it going to do God of War at 60 frames? There's not going to be a 60-frame option for that game. It's just 30, you know? The Horizon Zero Dawn, that game was at, like, 24 frames per second. So that one's not going to be the 60. Mass Effect Andromeda, they already said it's going to be 30 frames per second on PS4 Pro, PS4 Vanilla, Xbox One. So, you know, it's not even a 1080 60 machine, you know? So, to me, there's really, really no point.
I don't understand. It's a huge mess, man. They put themselves in a really bad spot. This is just me spitting out what I think, and I try to put myself in their shoes, but I ask you, because I'm interested in hearing what you have to say about it. I try to think about, what is it that PlayStation 4 Pro was created for? I try to think, did they get a whiff of Scorpio? Did they know it was coming?
Let me interrupt you.
Yeah.
Let me answer you. What the Pro was the same thing we all learned in history class ages ago. History has a tendency to repeat itself. And history repeated itself again. It's the Pro, my friend, with Sony being cocky motherfucker again. They thought they could come out. They thought they could use fancy words like T-flops, which the common public has absolutely no idea.
Now we all care about T-flops.
Right? Yeah, well now we do, because we're in competition. Now we're flopping, right, for T-flops against each other. But my point being is, they thought they were going to come out. They thought Microsoft was just going to do a regular slim. No real improvements. Maybe make the box smaller. No real improvements. And they were going to capitalize. They even, and Grab, you said this, right? They had the balls at their investors to say, we will sell 20 more million more hardware units this year. You will not, Sony, because you're exposed. And that's how cocky they were. They were cocky again. This is what they did when they launched the PS3. They thought they could do no wrong. So they're coming out with a four. And let me tell you something. If there was no Scorpio, that PS4 Pro would be $500. Sony's gonna laugh to the bank. It's $400 because now they're like, well, you know, we're trying to give you a little something for a little bit of money, you know what I'm saying? It's a little something. Like, and it was presented by a little man, Andrew House. So, you know, like, when it comes down to it, they're full of shit.
Yeah.
And now, so there's your answer, really, dude, is that they had, there is no, their concept, their thought process was to rob consumer. Because they thought Microsoft would get shit on their hands, where Microsoft didn't. That's why they're... Did you see the show they put on in New York? That looks like it was put together 15 minutes before they went live. When I tuned in, I thought it was a rehearsal.
They weren't even on the same page.
Oh, you know, I'm actually surprised they didn't charge more for the Pro because they do have a decent start.
That's how bad it is, crap.
Yeah, like I'm really surprised that they must have said, well, let's see how much we can get up front, sell these things or whatever. And then what about VR? Like, they're totally like throwing that under the bus. Now, Sean Murray's not alone under that bus because he's got a VR headset under there and exclusives.
Light sticks.
Yeah, like
and two cameras that they said were useless, yet they have two iterations of it.
Yes.
Oh, Kinect is a gimmick. Kinect's a gimmick. But we have two versions. Okay. Whatever.
That's Sony for you.
With PlayStation VR, I feel like it's already getting the shaft in. It's kind of too late for them to not release it. They've gone so deep with it that they have to release it. And I think they really need I honestly think they would love to save that money that they're doing to make a better console. I'm doing air quotes here with PS5, whatever it is that they want.
You know, I saw an interesting article today from Forbes. It was like, what happens if PlayStation VR doesn't go get the mainstream audience, right? What happens then? Right? Me and Bruce have been saying this forever. I've said it for months. I'm like, dude, VR has been out for months and nobody outside of the room cares. Nobody cares.
You and everybody on this podcast has seen, you've been to GameStop, right? You've been to anywhere. Go to Verizon, Mobile, go to AT&T, whatever you like. They all have the Galaxy, their Gear VR headset. There's nobody using it. It was like a kid waiting for his dad to get done talking, throwing it on the ground. Like, it's a piece of shit. It's no more than a Chuck E. Cheese coupon. It's worthless. My point being is that VR is a fad. No matter how you want to break it down, when you come home,
you know, and the article made a good point. It's like, look, VR is fun or whatever, but most people don't really want to mess with all that stuff, you know? And that's, I mean, look, and I can dig it. Like, you had Jay Hooft on your show, and he was like really hot selling it, like, oh, it's, you know, be on the mountaintops and, you know.
Well, think about it, though. He was selling an experience. So there's two different conversations here, crap. If you want to sit here and say, Mooch, try this thing out. I think this is a really cool, neat idea for futuristic, like, tendencies or for things that made me things I can't even imagine. Sure, fine. But when I do those experiences, I'm doing them for 10 and 30 minutes. I'm gaming for 2 hours. So I'm not going to wear that thing on my head. So my point is that it depends. I mean, I do know what you're saying, and it may fall off in the sales pitch, but remember, everything he was selling you or telling us was basically experiences. He didn't sit there at all and tell you, oh, you're missing out on this really cool game.
Yeah.
But there is no game.
Yeah, I hear you. It's experiences.
Yeah.
I don't see them doing well if VR doesn't take off. They need it to take off. So they're going to have to – they're going to have – The thing is that I've been saying for a while that I think it'll take off, but it's not for the right reasons, really. I think it'll take off because when they see it starting to struggle, you know they're going to drop the price. You know they're going to give away some tweet, you know, Wii Sports similar game that people are going to want to play for some
time.
You get rigs.
Yeah, you can get the Batman Simulator, you like an hour where you can kind of walk around in the Batcave and put on your helmet.
I mean, who doesn't want to put on a helmet, have an attached cable to you, then have it to put on your earbuds, and ignore the world around you?
What I love is the way people are like, yeah, you know, it's $400 for this thing. I'm like, yeah, it's $400, but you already have the camera and the, you know, all the other stuff. It's much more if you don't, and then plus all the space. Like, nobody's really talking about that. You know, I can remember Kinect. Oh my gosh, you need 5 feet in front of you? Holy cow, nobody would buy that. Even 5 feet, wow. This is like something like 60 square feet or something. I don't know what it is, but it's absolutely crazy.
Yeah, 60 square foot, man. I don't have that in my room. I just don't. There's no way that I can play that.
Yeah, so I don't know what they're thinking about that stuff.
for the people who don't have those boost sticks, I got good news for you. You can go to GameStop and get this greasy, oily, dirty, used up boost stick for $15.
I still got my original one from the PS3.
Like, did you like it?
You know what? I played, there was like a couple of games. They were okay. I think one of them was one of the Resistance games. It was pretty good on there. There was a SOCOM game you could play on there. I believe you could play Bioshock Infinite with it. There was some kind of spell casting game you could play with it. It was interesting. You know what I mean? It was okay for what it was. You know what I mean? It wasn't like great or anything, but it was like, you know, something that was different.
Like, okay, wouldn't you, this is what I think about when I'm talking about Mooch, wouldn't you feel embarrassed, Mooch Crap, if you were doing a project for class, and then you go into class, and the person who just went before you, the same exact project that you had, and now you have to go up next behind them, and convince everybody that your idea is cool. That's what I think about when it's Mooch, because they took that from the Wii, obviously. Nobody wants a Kinect, but then they have the PlayStation Eye camera, whatever the hell they want to call it. Nobody's gonna pay for an online service, but then now they're charging their,
you know, I gotta say something here, Fu, and I apologize, this is, I'm going off subject just slightly. Jimmy Moran just tweeted out 4 pictures of Gears of War 4, and I want to say something, because I think somebody said it on a podcast earlier this week or end of last week, but I gotta give them credit. I wish I could give them credit. You remember when Rod Ferguson said the Xbox One S is more powerful, and then Phil came out and was like, whoa, not really. It's not. But then we found out that frames per second were being registered at anywhere from 7 to 11% better. There's another tweak. Right, there was another tweak to the GPU. If you guys, here, I'm going to tweet it out. So if you don't follow Jamie Moran, you should be, A. But if you're not, I'm retweeting it right now. Open up the picture I just tweeted out of Marcus's face. That's the in-game footage. And let me tell you something. I'm going to go ahead and be on Team Rod here, because I think that Xbox One S has the balls to compete with pretty much anything Sony's got out or coming out. Because the Xbox One X, man, between HDR, you see what Forza Horizon 3 is doing?
Well, did you see that article where that PC magazine was like, we're playing it on the Xbox One because of HDR, and that's not available on the PC version.
Right. And they're saying that it looks amazing. Like, PC people. Like, that's insane. I'm just saying, look, you don't have to, I'm not going to sit here and be like, oh, I swear it's not going to buy. Look, chipsets are chipsets, okay? Numbers are numbers. They are what they are. But there's something going on, and maybe it's the custom GPU. Microsoft just throws out a program to it. You know, we are 3 years into a closed box, okay? Things can happen. Things that Microsoft has planned that us sitting at our desks at home with a microphone and calling on YouTube, we don't know, and we're not supposed to know. And you know what? I don't want to know. I really don't. You know what? The games are stunning. They're gorgeous. They're playing amazing. There's no way. Gears of War, I don't give a shit what Metacritic says. We've got a 91 on Forza 3, and Gears is going to get above a 90. My personal opinion, if it doesn't, fuck all the haters out there. You know what I mean? And if you don't believe the haters out there, just come to Food's chat box. A plenty of them.
Oh, gotcha! I'm not a graphics guy. Damn.
Is this something? I mean, come on. That's no bullshit, people. That's the game.
There's no way that's not going to be on Xbox One, because
yeah, right? No, it's 480. I like that. Every time someone talks about Xbox One, the P's drop and so does the sales. Come on, move.
That's good, right? People, like remember when we brought it up that they mentioned they only sold 40 million?
Yeah.
Guess what? They're back into that, although 7 months ago it was like close to 45 million.
Yeah.
Remember, I was telling you, I was like, probably be by 50 by the time the pro comes out. You're like, what are you talking about, crap?
Yeah, I'm like, this is ridiculous. I can stop with the Xbox One. But it's the latest Xbox One numbers. 15 million? We dropped 5 million in the past 2 years.
Like 18 million or 16 million. That's like hilarious to me.
No, The hate is just unbelievable. And that, you know, that's just what drives me to do more and more podcasts and get the word out. And, you know, it's just that there's a hypocrisy. Forget the band, right? Sony fans are lemmings. They're going to walk into a pit of fire. That's fine. That, it is what it is. Everybody's got that. And there's people who walk into a pit of fire, and I just smoke them all, walk back in. They're like, these are killing you. They're like, there's two more packs. So it's just, like, the point is, that's fine.
Two more.
Let me get two, because one, fuck one. I want two.
That's,
you know, I'm dying on my clock, not yours. So, you know, like, the whole thing is, like, that's fine. People are loving. That's great. But the fact that the media has the gall to intimidate and counter Phil. Like, when Phil was up there on three, he said, we're giving you an HDR. We're going to give you 4 points. The first thing wasn't, Phil, thank you. That's awesome. You've been asking for more. What's for that? No, what was the first thing he said? Phil, are you implying $10,000? Is that what you're implying? Is that what you're telling me? IGN? You know who I am? Like, and now you've got Andrew Hauskas up there and you won last week. Says the same thing and they're like, yo. Oh, drama, huh? You know, it was like, unbelievable. I'm like, glorious applause when Andrew House and the Lollipop Gang came out and told everybody. I couldn't believe the amount of people that don't question Sony. Sony said something, we're giving you HDR and you're PS4 vanilla. If Microsoft said that, they would be like, excuse me, Albert Vanilla. Isn't that horseshit? Did you can't do it, actually? Well, technically, you know, nobody said anything there. You know, people said, even Brian McCaffrey came out and said it. Well, it's really nice that Sony's giving away HDR to all their consumers. That's really great. And next week, they're getting Unicorn. Like, what the fuck else are they giving away that doesn't exist?
Sorry, Booze. For what? That's fine, man.
Crash used to it. Crash is over there.
Come back to
Crash watching Thursday Night Football.
I am.
I'll be back.
You can watch it on Twitter, so
Twitter.
Yeah, they struck a deal off the option. They did a couple, I think, literally. I got Roger, Doug Martin, Jerry, Sammy Watkins, Golden Tate, No, that's all I had. I went into a league with like 11 other players.
One's all right, and then Sammy Watkins has got an ankle that's quite special. You used to, you know, the little stop that he is.
I got it. My problem is that you don't need to have those full drafts in this year. So I parted ways and made peace with my loss.
Hey, if it makes you feel better, Ford, that's what a lot of the PlayStation users have said the same thing over the years.
Exactly. Let me get back.
Because in 2013, they thought they were going to be getting games. Instead, they got one game per Christmas, and they should be getting one.
No, I give it to them though. They're loyal. If that was a relationship, and their relationship was falling apart. I mean, they're that kind of girl.
It's an abusive relationship. Yeah. They're getting smacked around, and they're like, oh, I'm sorry. Go back, and they're like, okay, but next time, and then the next time they come around, they still are getting smacked, and they're like, you know, okay, it's okay. You know what I mean? That's what it is. Yeah. And it's sad.
It is sad.
I hate saying the word facts, because every time I say facts, people are like, just say facts, it is. Well, I mean, it is. If I tell you they have four games on the holiday lineup, they just do. If they have HDR, they just do. I mean, they don't believe in all that. I stood in line behind the guy at GameStop, and he was buying Destiny, and he was standing there with his hot as hell girlfriend. And made this stupid comment that made me extremely upset, because I was thinking, wow, this is the kind of girl he gets, and he doesn't know what the fuck to be talking about. He said he has the Destiny for PlayStation, and he said, yeah, Destiny for PlayStation. PlayStation. They get a bunch of stuff on there that Xbox doesn't get. And I'm like, what do you mean? I was like, Xbox does get it. It's timed. And he's like, nah, man, you can get this and this and that. And I'm like, yeah, it's timed. And I grabbed the box from his hand. I turned it upside down. Right on the bottom, it says, timed exclusivity until at least fall of next year. I'm like, what is that? Like, I'm pointing at it. I'm like, what is that right there? You know, they don't
careful food. Careful food. I said something very, I said way less to somebody in line at a GameStop. You're right now, there's three or four people making a video about you and saying that you took it out of his hand and you hit him with a cane and then you stepped on him and then you lit a cigarette that you don't smoke.
Do
and
you
put
remember
it out
your
face.
True name?
No. Sorry, food, you're exposed.
Say no more, nominee. Yeah.
So,
but if no
careful.
One tells him, Roxas will.
Especially in your chat box there, you've got
it's
some
best
lovely,
he doesn't know the truth.
Trolls. You should definitely give
hey,
me the
you're
moderator.
You're that pickpocket. Those look like Mooch Maniac trolls, dude.
No, they're all blocked from my channel.
Oh, are they?
I don't see any. The guys that were ass clowns earlier, some of these guys are mine. They're with, you know, they're Mooch guys, but.
I just love the guy in our chat that his name is Flip Bayless.
Flip Bayless is awesome, by the way. he comes to every
Cypher,
every
strike roster. A pose, you know?
I just want
how's this?
He is to know that
that's
I
totally perfect, you know?
Says.
I think he also disagrees with Skip
how about
Bayless,
one more, you know?
The Flip Bayless.
What's that
I,
for?
I also disagree with everything. What's
those
the
freaks in the white jacket.
Skip Bayless, you know? Bayless is a marketing
cakewalk.
Genius, right? He does.
Yeah.
People
what
don't
are
even realize
things?
It. He doesn't believe
outsiders,
half the stuff he
that's
says,
what.
But he says the crazy stuff.
And
if
they
so
don't rise up to the rules around here,
Twitter,
I might have to
show,
take disciplinary
me of
measures.
Somebody, I know.
Exactly,
oh, yeah.
Right?
Cypher's always
and
looking
so,
after the town,
so
you know?
Basically, he'll say something, and then he'll be wrong, and then you'll tweet him on Twitter, you're wrong, Skip! Ha-ha, you're wrong, but he don't care because you're already following him and watching it. So
he's reading your tweet, smoking a cigar.
What's some of the stuff that he said?
Wait up!
Who, Skip Bayless?
Hey! No chickening out of the tournament tomorrow!
So Skip,
we'll be waiting,
to be on
you know?
First Take on ESPN, and he used to do the counterpoints with Stephen A. Smith, and now he got big because when he did Dealers, he basically said the opposite of what was going to happen just to get, like, news. Like, they, you know, like the gaming media. You know, yeah. They do anything they can do the opposite to get clickbait. He's that. Yeah. He got big from that, and now he's
so
got a huge deal.
You hung out with
Cypher's
gang today?
One, and now
no,
instead of sitting across from
like
Stephen
that.
A, I think he's sitting across from like
oh, yeah.
Shannon Sharp or
how was
I
the beach? Wasn't
for
that
the,
today?
The noise earlier.
We didn't
they decided
go.
To do a random fucking
it wouldn't
fire
be the
drill,
same without you, right?
In this building, so yeah. Sorry.
That's awesome. Yeah, so Skip Bayless will be like, "Holy
how
say,
about
he'll
we go tomorrow?"
Stupid, like
he'll be
the
like,
"Dallas Cowboys are going to win the World Championship this year."
I promised
with,
I'd be somewhere.
Dak Prescott,
yeah,
quarterback. You know what I mean? It's like the most ridiculous stuff ever. You know, it's just crazy.
Like if LeBron James doesn't win a championship this year,
he's LeBron choke or whatever. You know what I mean?
He's going
to
go
you
play
and
for
I
the
have
White
to
Sox.
Make fun
yeah.
That way,
exactly.
Who wins?
Exactly.
Four of us
so,
put
yeah,
the prize.
He gets
okay,
he says really
you're
like,
on. You two are gonna clean up.
Hot takes.
Go get him.
And then
he gets hits, man. Every hit he gets, that's ad revenue.
Exactly. It's like he's a genius.
He is. He should run for president.
He's a damn genius, man.
He's Mr. Garrison. I'll go. I guess I'll end things here. I wanted to keep you guys for a good
I'm
solid hour.
Here.
I didn't want to have you stay here for the majority of the night. I want to get you guys definitely back to gaming or spending time with your family or being polarizing. So thanks again. I wanted to get you guys together just because I do podcasts and stuff like that. Mooch, I'm surprised, Mooch, you don't remember.
Was that nominee
this
made
was
of
my
data?
First foodcast because you
no.
Were on my first foodcast.
Nominee,
yeah, but you didn't really.
I
knew I was going to fall victim to that, but I mean,
look what
you've
done now.
A bunch of pine salt. I don't remember any of
she's
that.
Exactly.
Me
exactly.
On my control.
I mean, no, my whole thing is this because
calm
this
down.
Is the first time I seen you do the logo.
It doesn't
you know,
matter.
Put the guests out there and do it like.
As
I think
long
before
as
you
nominee
were like, hey,
accomplishes
join me for
a goal.
Remember, at Mooch 1978.
We needn't worry about what performs
rocks. Yeah. You know, I was like, so this is a lot. This is like, I thought this was your way of really like waving the flag, being like, yo, this is my podcast.
Yeah, I get what you're saying. It's just back then, my social life, because I had one back then, was dude, it was crazy. Like, I'd spend like an hour and a half.
It's up
two
to me.
Hours at the maximum in my own
only
house.
Only the Keyblade
like,
master can open the secret door.
Doing homework
and change the world
all the time. So I get a little bit of
extra. Well, I'm not gonna betray Sora either.
No, I got news for you, bro.
My friends are my power.
It's not a Debbie Downer thing either. It's just not. It's called life. It is what it is. You know, like when you hit 18 or 20 or 21. And I'm completely stereotyping. You're the type of person that love bars, love going out. You wanted to be social. You know what you didn't do anymore? You didn't put baseball cards in your spokes and ride around with your neighbor, right? You were doing that. Then when you're 20, right? And then you're 28.
Lead me into everlasting
28, 29, 30, which is the era you're going into.
Forget.
You know what you don't do? You don't just go spend
pointless
nights.
There's no way you're taking Kyrie's heart.
Club with like three or four people you kind of know. Like that's what you did at 21, right? And then once you get to 35, 36, what you do is you don't even do the mingling shit like that. I come home from work.
Kyrie.
I got shit I got to take care of with the family. There's stuff I got to do that if I want to do podcasting or if I
we may never meet again.
I got to do what you call it
but
work,
we'll never forget
each
other.
Do a good job at work.
No matter
you
where
do
we
you
are,
do there. Then you want to
our hearts will bring us together again.
Or your better half or whatever's going on. Your
take
kids
this.
And that. And then what you do is you try
it's
to get
my lucky
game
charm.
Again, you know
be sure to bring it back to me.
For the
don't
next
worry,
364 days.
Promise.
And it's not a bad thing. It's just the
don't
way
ever
it is. Once people figure
wherever
out
go,
that's just the way it
I'm
is,
with
life
you.
Gets a lot easier. It's the people that keep fighting that they don't want to do tomorrow that make it so hard to wake up tomorrow. It's not that big of a deal, people. Just repeat the cycle. Tomorrow's going to be what today was with a little bit different weather. So, I mean, you know, yeah, life has a couple of, you know, a thunderstorm here or there. I mean, I'm being like, hypothetical there. Sometimes it's a thunderstorm. Sometimes it's something that happens in life. But you know what? Life moves on, and we need to just get back on the horse and do it. And that's the same thing. Like I say it to you all the time, Food. You know what I mean? Me and you've talked a lot behind the scenes. Life will continue to move on regardless of what we do. Do the best you can. I was proud to see you started this up. I think you should do it every week. I think what you should do is get amazing people that are on Twitter that love games to come on and talk with you about everything that's going on. There's a lot of people that are willing to do that. And then rotate some of the people that you've been on. You know, Crap, myself, Dealer, Zaire. Grab people, have them come on. And it's just, this. It's a great, great tool for you, I think, especially it keeps things structured through your schooling and such. So I thank you for having me on tonight, too. Yeah, I appreciate it. I really wanted to do it again because, you know, the last time I really had fun, I did a few podcasts, I had a good time, but I mean, like, in terms of having more than me and someone else, more than two people, it's been a while since I really got to have
fun. Who are you
going to
root for?
I did a podcast, I'll say, about a month ago with a few guys. That was really cool. And that's what made me think about doing this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, struggle fiends of Twilight Town, it's time for summer's most sizzling clash.
Like, I don't know what's up with him. So
that's right. He does a podcast with
the day for a struggle and title match.
I'm not so busy.
Who will be the one to break through the ranks and take on our champion, Cypher?
Cypher!
I swear. Now,
and who will lead today as our new struggle champion?
The notification will tell you about these subscribers to our video. So, like, now I just kind of, instead of getting all these notifications, I narrowed it down to like,
yes, the crowd is fired up, so you know what comes next.
Yeah, but then I don't want to turn off the phone. I don't want to have to turn no notifications.
But I did button 6 times instead of 4, goddammit.
Hey now, it's time to introduce today's combatants, the four bad boys who struggled their way through the preliminaries.
A lot of fun.
Regular finalist and head of the Twilight Disciplinary Committee, Cypher.
Well, the problem was at the six or seven
completely out of nowhere. Who knew he'd make it so far this year?
BB!
An underground favorite and local attitude problem. Hayner! It's his first trip to the finals.
You
and struggler number four,
either,
who happens to be my absolute favorite customer,
Roxas! Like, I always say, like, I'm surprised. Yeah.
So, who will
really
win
well
this sweltering summer struggle?
I always watch your shit. You know, I like the way that you
who will
do
take
it,
home
dealer,
the grand
like,
prize?
You and I'm not saying
the summa cum laude of struggle,
like
the Ford Crystal Trophy!
I like how you
and
guys
a chance
a
to take on our defending champion,
like
Setzer.
Some of the numbers, you do your research, you actually grab articles.
It won't be
like,
long now, folks. I suggest
said
our challengers
okay
go over
like,
the official struggle rules before we begin.
He said, okay?
Yeah, so you knew exactly what Albert Penelo said, just like what
absolutely
I was saying. Like,
exactly.
Yeah, I'm sure people not everybody like agrees with all my opinions with all this technology and Zen and all that, because, you know, everyone thinks Sin's going to be in the Scorpio. I myself am the only motherfucker I know in the community that I really don't think they're going to